Is this the feeding Diggy strategy na pwede natin makita or normal Diggy?
I feel like kailangan mag-feeding strategy ni Blackness dito to disrupt the early game presence of the Lancelot. Kasi kailangan na i-delay yung game ni Lancelot up to the time na kayang-kaya ng lumaban ni Granger and mag-ube yung Blacklist International. And what the Diggy provides for them is the teamfight presence kasi may eliminate nila yung threat ni Kufra. So I like the adjustment. Instead of going for the Rafaela to help the Granger snowball or earlier on, you completely shut down the idea of the lineup ng kalaban with the Diggy pick.
So kailangan maging maingat ng RSGMY. We still don't know if this is a feeding Diggy for this game. They have the Beatrix for the final pick, and we're entering the game once again. Can Blacklist finish off this series with this Diggy? That the Popol and Koopa na to, kasama si Esson. Let's see. Pero ito ah, gusto ko lang maiba ng topic. Beatrix, nagiging magandang pick for some teams, and especially Ludiels.
I think Beatrix, especially pag nilagay mo yan sa gold lane, may ability yan na makabukad during the early mid-game phase. At meron din siyang late-game scaling. Especially if makakagulat ka dahil kadalasan pag yung shotgun na natamaan ka na sobrang melee, masasaktan ka talaga. Pero tignan mo to, pakito. Man, nasasaktan.
Man, speaking of shotgun, actually Beatrix yun. Yung Beatrix dito, nag-gets ko na din Midnight Umi. Kaya rin nag-digi. Pantayan natin yung Beatrix.
Hindi finit. Ginawang baby gold lane.
Patay. Ayun na nga. Nabanggit mo to Umi. Masakit ang Beatrix siya. Pero kapag na-shutdown mo ng ganito, ang bilis ng farm ng Harit, ang bilis ng pwedeng makuhang gold ng Harit dito. Baby Harit, binibi this time ni Esson, si Oheb.
And looking at yung ano na yun, ha, yung matchup na yun, pag dinagdaga mo ng Diggy si Oheb, mabibigyan mo ng protection ang isang Harith na kailangan talaga ng oras para mag-scale up. And against a Beatrix, Harith early game versus early game Beatrix, pag natamaan ka, yung sniper na ganyan, masakit talaga yan. Shotgun, masakit din. There's a lot of options para sa RSGMY on this gold lane. Pero dahil binaby ni Esson dito si Oheb, nagiging masaya lang ang buhay. Happy life si Oheb sa gold lane.
Happy life. At tama, nabanggit mo pa kanina, kaya ding sumabay ng isang Benedetta sa Pakito, tama ba? Kaibigang Umi. So with that, ilamang sa lahat ng lanes ang Blacklist.
Well, di naman lahat kasi lucky din si Benedetta against the Pakito. But what Blacklist International has on the mid game is the insane mobility around the map to contest objectives. Pero to RSGMY, nauna sila kasi nakapwesto na si Zacus and Lancelot kasi yan.
Meron sila ditong pang-counter go ng Diggy. But this time si Wise ang masasapak ni Kaiser. So yeah, tama ka naman, Midnight. Kaiser still is doing great. Pero ang tinitignan natin dito is yung shutdown sa baba. Dahil naku, yung Harit ay masakit pa din. Izanami.
Ano?
Ganda naman yung knock-up na yun.
Maganda yung knock-up. At Venus!
Kagat ni Kupa.
Umabot na
yun! Isa pa! Sayang!
Nabiten para kay Venus. Akala rin siguro ni Venus malamatilda pa yung galaw niya kanina. Pero kasi hindi lumilipad ang aso. Pero tignan natin, muntikan makakuha si Venus ng kill. And yun yung mga risky plays na madalas nating nakikita sa side ng Blacklist na pwedeng mapitas. Nangyari din yun nung isang araw. So this time, at least yung RSG nakakuha ng magagandang kuha.
Yeah, and RSGMY right now, nakuha nila yung turtle, nakakuha siya ang pick-off, they've survived the early game damage coming in from Venus. They're on their way into trying to start this potential snowball. Pero kailangan nila tandaan na they need to shut down Oheb. And habang sinasabi ko, nangyari din yun. So RSGMY, medyo nakuha na nila yung pace. But let's look at the gold lead. Di pa naman ganun kalala.
Isang libo lang. Pero Umi, binanggit mo ha, you need to shut down certain heroes sa side ng Blacklist. Naisahan na si Venus, naisahan na din si Oheb, si Edward na lang ang natitira. May onting counter go ang Blacklist International dito, but again, this is a game na kahit papano pwedeng sumabay na yung RSGMY, unlike game number one.
Yeah.
Na snowball talaga yung lineup ng Blacklist.
Actually, this is the threat of what Blacklist adjusted into, no? Yung Diggy na pinang-baby nila against the Harit. Yes, you gave Harit enough time to be able to farm up against the Beatrix, pero problema kasi hindi naman yun yung pinakaunang timer na kailangan nila. Ang kailangan nilang gawin in this game is pahirapan yung Lancelot, kasi once you give Lakesia the early game that he needs, which he did get, mahihirapan sila pagdating ng mid-game. Kahit kano kaya man itong Harit na ito, mahihirapan yung Greedjoy.
Pero mahirapan din si Zacus sa kanyang pagkuha ng initiation dahil nagamit na ang Time Journey. Second Turtle for this game. Who's gonna get it? Lamang ang RSGMY sa position pero sumabog ang mukha ni Kaiser. Wala siyang kampe pala doon. Pero this time makuha nila Turtle. Sabog. Pero ang kapalit ay sumasabog ng mga mukha ng kanyang mga kampe. Dahil si Edward ay nandito na kasi kinakagat-gagat sabay hinila pabalik. But still, it is a 2-4 Turtle trade. Blacklist International kahit papano ay nakakuha ng onting paghabol sa early game lead ng RCMY.
Yeah, ganda ng focus din ng Blacklist. No? Alam din nila na hindi ganun kadali kunin yung Turtle against the Lancelot. Pagtalon ni Zacus, all of their eyes turned to the heroes of RCMY. Pero nagagal na si Zacus, sinundan yung surod na hero. Kasi again, hindi mo kailangan i-contest yung objective ni Lancelot. Kailangan mo makipag-trade against RSG right now.
Yeah, trade is the name of the game. At ang gaganda na nagiging trade ng RSG, ha? May mga nakukuha silang kills na hindi nakakabawi ang Blacklist.
Oh, definitely. Mm-hmm. Pero tingnan natin to, ha. Nasaan dito si Venus. He's gonna go for the 2v1, pero mukhang makakatakas naman pala.
Yeah. Actually, tutuloy pa rin si Zacus dito. Walang tigil, no? For this game, Zacus, tuloy-tuloy ang kanyang pag-initiate. Nice. Hindi pa rin tapos. Lexia, welcome in with the Battle of
Lexia. Edward! Cooldown na.
And the final blow para kay Edward. There you have it. But there you have it as well. Zacus will also flicker out. 15 seconds down si Lexia. Eson will fall down. Nakikita natin this time yung pagiging aggressive ng RGMY. Zacus, hindi niya nahuli agad si Venus. Mm. Pero hinabol niya ang gandulo. Ito pala yung dapat na paraan.
Yeah, and this is why Edward is MVP of MPL Philippines Season 7. Kaiser, gonna flicker out. Medyo boy pa naman siya doon. Pero men, ang ganda ng Electo Final Blow doon ni Edward.
Buti na lang kamo nag-cooldown doon yung mga skills ni Lancelot. At nakakuha ng magandang pasok si Edward. But this is looking bad. If you're a fan of Blacklist International, we're now seeing that RSGMY, sila yung nagdidikta ng tempo ngayon. Nakakuha sila ng magandang early game. At ngayon, kung ikaw ang Blacklist, paano ka makakabalik?
I think, again, you just don't need to trade against... I mean, you don't need to contest RSGMY. Trade lang talaga.
Oo. Trade lang talaga. Parang ganito. Kuha ng isa, tapos pwede ka mag-back. Tama ba?
Yeah. You just continue getting this trades against RSGMY. Kasi again, mayroon kang ano eh, mayroon kang timer na hinihintay. Eson!
Okay, there you go. First time makakuha si Wise ng Turtle. Pero going back to your point, Midnight.
Lancelot kasi yung RSGMY. So you, again, you don't need to contest the objectives away from them. What Blacklist International can do is do whatever they need to do. Kumbaga, huwag mong pansinin si RSGMY. Kung kailangan mo i-trade yung top lane, go for the top lane. Kung ikaw contest kasi si Turtle, turn your attention towards the heroes. Kasi kaya din naman lumaban ng Blacklist International just to stay afloat para pantay yung gold, hindi lumalamang yung RSGMY. Kasi once na nakarating na kayo na late game, you are in an advantage. Kahit may Lunox yung RSGMY, meron kasi kayo pang zone with the Popol and Koopa, meron kayong anti-teamfight with the Diggy, and yung damage output ng Blacklist International will just continuously scale.
Yeah, so choose your fights wisely. Pero nako, talagang pinipilit ni Zacus, pare!
Nako, yan na.
Pero kailangan natin kumounter go ng side ng Blacklist. Ito yung maganda this time sa RSG. Pinipilit ni Zacus ng pinipilit kahit na medyo awkward yung laban. To be honest, ang awkward ng mga ganong setups, yung setup niya kanina kay Venus, awkward yun. Ngayon, pati dito sa baba, under the tower. But wow! So, ito ba yung paraan? Ito ba yung paraan? Talagang gulatin mo ng ganon?
Well, looking, that's one way to do it. But RSGMY, they're pushing their advantages not only in one lane. Pupunta din sila ng mid lane. They're trying to get objectives. Pero papasok dito Blacklist.
Sabi ng Blacklist, kami din. Manggugulat! Si Wise ay mega kill na pala! Anong gulat-gulat? Walang gulat sa amin dahil si Ohev ay makakuha ng magandang Zaman Force. Pawing-pawi. Trade after trade. Tama yung sinabi mo, Midnight. Choose your fights wisely and Kaiser. Wise. Sumasay ko pa ng gilid movements and si Edward pa yung makakuha ng top lane. RGMY biglang nawala yung lead nila.
Sobrang lupit ni Edward. Niretry siya ni Lancelot para di siya makahabol. Pero sabi ni Edward, Pinoy ako, hahabulin pa rin kita. Yung Thorn Rose, in eye for an eye. At naabot siya nung Death Sonata. Talagang walang takas si Lexia. Kala niya, galing niya mag-Lancelot eh.
Wala.
Pero galing mag-Benedetto ni Edward eh.
Wala, season MVP yan eh.
Kabisado ni Edward yung Benedetta, kabisado niya rin yung Lancelot. Napakadaling ma-eye for an eye. Akala natin lamang na yung RSG. Pero mas akala lang pala yon. Akala mo lang lamang. Pero hindi, hindi, hindi.
Oh, alam mo naman, Manjin, ang mga Pilipino, nagpapabugbog lang yan sa una.
Pinapasarap,
lang, pinapasarap lang talaga.
Oh. Para naman makaramdam ng laro si, oh, ano, si RCMY. Pero kidding aside, no, Blacklist International, again, ang ganda na nagiging sagot nila, hindi na masyado pinagpapapansin yung RSGMY. Even though may mga fights na nasa harap sila, yung magkakaharapan talaga sila, magkaiba ng idea, magkaiba ng objective. Sige, contest yung turtle namin, yeah, heroes yung papansin namin. Sige, contest yung mid-tower namin, nasa bottom lane kami, pupush namin yung tower, yeah, nyo. Kasi meron naman tayo taga-hold. Again, Edward is the pillar of this playstyle. Blacklist International, what they're doing right now is whatever RSGMY wants, nandun si Edward. Siya lagi yung pantapat. Tapos susunod na lang yung Blacklist.
Nakakahanap sila dito ng magagandang trade kahit papano. Kahit nawawalan sila ng mga towers, at this time sila yung magsiset ng tempo. But still, RCMY respecting the damage of Blacklist and protecting this tower up until now.
And I just want to commend yung positioning ni Wise at ni Oheb. For the longest time, nung lamang pa ang RCMY, naiiwasan nila ang key abilities such as the Thorn Rose and Phantom Execution. Yun na nga, hindi mo masyado nararamdaman ang damage ng isang Lancelot even in his, ooh, power spike. Pinikyan ng tatlo, namatay ang Lunox mo, kuya.
Izanami disrespecting ang mga putok ng bala ni Wise. 514, Umi, kakasabi mo lang yung positioning ni Edward at ni Wise. Baliwala yung kalamangan ng RSG. Kinocomment natin yung RSG kanina ng early...
maganda naman kasi yung ginagawa ni RSG.
Nung early stages of the game. But again, yung mga maliliit na trades ang ginagawa ng Blacklist and yung micro mechanics talaga, yeah, of positioning ng side ng Blacklist, yun yung nakakuha ngayon. Umabot na tayo sa point na sila na ang, oo, lamang.
Alam mo, sa sobrang ipit na ipit yung RSGMY at nababaliw sila sa ginagawa ni Blacklist, si Edward, one full minute, nagpo-push siya may bottom lane na walang response. Kasi si Zacus, one full minute din na nasa mid lane and wala pa nga sila nagawa. Pinagpaparil lang ni Wise, si Izanami.
Three hits?
Oo.
Hits.
Yung isang,
well,
Lunox.
Ano, isang Rhapsody to death sonata. Pero,
So 6 hits.
Oh, 9 bullets.
9 bullets. Oh, pero tingnan ko. Oh, saglitan lang 'yon. Isang sapak nga lang ni
isang Kuya Pompiang.
Ayun na 'yung ube. Ayun na 'yung ube. Ayun na pinatikim
what
na.
What time is it? It's ube time. Hila para kay Zacus at ayun 'yung pasok ni Edward. Nako. Ang dami nating sinabi ng early stages of the game, pero bumalik lang tayo sa game number 1. It's now Blacklist International controlling this game. At nagre-react na lang ang RSGMY.
Ayan, again, rinse and repeat. Kung saan man gusto ni RSGMY, nandun si Edward. Si Blacklist International may sariling objective. Shift kagad sa hero. Gusto niyo kami contest? Dito kami sa hero. Paulit-ulit lang ang gagawin ng Blacklist to.
Sa sobrang galit na ni Wise dito, pati yung Kramer, inuultihan niya na.
Diba?
Kasi bitin yung damage yung Dead Sonata para sa isang hero. O sayang to. Gamitin natin sa Kramer.
Dagdag gold na rin. At this Lord will be uncontested for the side of Blacklist International. And again, this is already 12 minutes 30 yeah. seconds inside the game. A Luminous Lord will be marching alongside the Blacklist International squad. Good news to para sa mga agents na nanonood.
Oh no. Looking like another dominant game for the side of Blacklist. Again, I'll be honest, akala ko talaga yun na yung parang game plan para matalo mo yung Blacklist. Gulatin mo sila sa mga awkward na laban na ginagawa ni Zacus kanina.
Edward, pumupuesto doon, no?
Oo. Pero it's all about the puesto. Mm-hmm. Puesto Nation! Edward, papasok ngayon. Brilliance out si Lunox. Pero na naman yung mga
bala. Uy, hila!
Hila, dulce! Sabi dito ni
Oheb!
Isa
and
pa?
Oheb, hindi
bigyan
pa rin
pa
tapos. You can't see me. Harriet coming in. Pasok din dito si Edward. Lahat sila nakikita ng camera. Lahat sila may highlight moments. Blacklist International owning RSG.
Nababaliw na yung RSGMY. Ang daming nangyayari. Parang ang dami nilang kalaban.
Ang daming nag-exhibition. Mm-hmm. And wow! Blacklist International. Maaga daw tayong uuwi ngayon. They will break the code! And syempre, wala namang kabayas-bayas, panalo ang Pilipinas!
Nako, wala talagang kabayas-bayas, pero hello undefeated streak! 6-0 para sa Blacklist International.